behind us. You want to talk a little bit about what's going on with Fresh Thyme, because we've been waiting.
Well, we've been waiting too, and that's right, Joni. Pretty exciting time here on Farmington Road. The downtown Farmington Center, which is in the heart of downtown, has been undergoing redevelopment for about the last 4 months. There is a brand new fresh produce market coming into town, Fresh Thyme. And Fresh Thyme is part of the downtown Farmington Center. Late last year, and then through the earlier part of this year, we worked very closely with Fresh Thyme on staging the demolition of what was 1959-1960 construction. You might recall there was an A&P grocery here at one point in time.
Before my time, but yes, I've
but
been
yes.
told.
And it eventually transitioned over the years to several different uses. I believe Farmer Jack occupied the space at one time. I think a Damon Hardware, and eventually an Office Depot. But that space has been vacant for a number of years through the economic downturn, through the recession. But working with the owners of the downtown Farmington Center, Kimco, and with Fresh Thyme, we are repurposing a portion of the downtown Farmington Center. And we're looking very forward to them coming online sometime this summer. I think currently the target grand opening is August 18th.
And there was a little bit of a delay. I know they were pretty optimistic in the beginning about when they were going to have this exterior construction done. Could you talk a little bit about some of the conditions that happened early in the construction?
Sure. Well, as I indicated, the downtown Farmington Center, the initial big building here, which houses now the new Fresh Thyme, and certainly from Fitness 19 all the way down to Cedars Restaurant, which is now going to be a new owner there, Laziz Mediterranean Food. This whole big building here was built in a location where we had a farm and single-family homes. You might recall that the Warner Cheese Factory was in the parking lot here at one time. So there's been a lot of uses over time that have transitioned to what you see here. But when they got into the job, tearing down the old A&P for construction of the new Fresh Thyme, they realized there were some existing limitations based upon soil conditions. The soil conditions upon which the A&P grocery was built were such to where they found that they had organic materials in there. But the A&P was able to be built based upon the construction practices at that time, right, and what was required. However, with the Fresh Thyme construction and the support structure, the steel that needed to be put in place, the footing, the foundation necessary, they needed to excavate some of the old soil and put in engineered fill and then construct the footings, the foundation, and the steel structure now supporting the new Fresh Thyme.
All right. Now, there has been a lot of new, I don't know, I guess what you'd call new uses, not necessarily new construction, but new uses in downtown Farmington. Do you think that Fresh Thyme has kind of spurred some of that interest?
Well, we hope so, and we think so, because if you look around downtown, you can see the results of the city's planning efforts over the last number of years. You know, the city really positioned itself to become redevelopment ready by creating the City of Farmington Vision Plan in 2013, also to the Downtown Area Plan, which was completed in 2015, and those planning guides, tools, really set the stage for the redevelopment that you see now. And yeah, I think that what you see down at Grove Street with the Groves Retail Center really kind of set the tone itself, and there's been a domino effect resulting now in what you see here for Fresh Thyme.
And could you give us a little, maybe a little glimpse of what's ahead in maybe the next few months in downtown Farmington?
Sure. We're looking at a pretty significant re-tenanting, reoccupancy of vacant space in the downtown. The last I checked with our Downtown Development Authority Executive Director, Annette Knowles, I think we are now probably over 90%, 91% or so in re-tenanting space in the downtown that's been available and reoccupancy. That's going to continue. You know, we keep getting interest in our downtown because it's very attractive with the redevelopment and what is becoming, you know, new and in place. It's attracting other developer, investor, retailer interest. We've just put out a second round of RFPs for the Maxfield Training Center, and that's also in the heart of downtown on the north side of Grand River. And other things in downtown too. You know, eventually we're hoping to see the Farmington Road streetscape realized. There was a slight delay in that with some financing, but we're still looking to hopefully see that implemented in the next several years. A lot of improvements along Grand River that you're seeing right now as well, business, and we're looking to have a mill and fill of the roadway in 2017. That'll improve Grand River, and I think that's going to, you know, certainly also follow down Farmington Road in terms of the impact there. So quite an exciting time in Farmington.
It certainly is. We're on the road to recovery.
Yes, we are.